Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Dear brothers and sisters, I am Imam Hassan Akbar and welcome to the 17th episode of Hadith Revival. In today's episode, we will be taking one hadith from the famous book, 40 Hadith You Should Know. My dear brothers and sisters, this hadith is dealing with the issue of haya, shyness. Is it a trait that is only for women to have and to possess? Is this a trait that men should have and should carry themselves with, being shy and having this shyness in their dealings with the people and being in front of the people? Is it permissible for a man to be shy? Or should men be the one that are brave and those who are in the forefront and always challenging and loud and obnoxious? What is the ruling on shyness? Where does it fall in our religion? We, inshallah, will be discussing this and more in today's episode. My dear brothers and sisters, we praise Allah and we thank Allah and we seek Allah's help and we seek Allah's assistance. Inna alhamdulillah, nahmaduhu wa nasta'inuhu wa nastaghfiru wa na'udhu billahi min shururi anfusina wa min sayyi'ati a'malina. May yahdihillahu fala mudillala wa may yudlil fala hadiyala. Wa ashadu an la ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika la. Wa ashadu anna muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluh. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has indeed blessed us tremendously. From among those great blessings is that He has given us hidayah and guidance. Allah has guided us to this religion of al-Islam. For indeed, when you turn on your television, listen to your radio, you find that there are many different ideas that are floating around all the time around you. And people are calling to their way. Whether they are trying to win you over and call you to a different religion or a different type of lifestyle. They are calling you to become gangsters. They are calling you to be alternative lifestyles, to all of these alternative families, families in which there are two fathers. We ask Allah's protection from this. Families in which there are two mothers. We ask Allah's protection from this. There are so many different ideas revolving around society. But indeed, even though we are surrounded by different speech, different kalam, different ideas and philosophies and statements, alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has guided us and has selected us and has chosen for us to be from among those who believe that there is no God worthy of worship but Him, and from among those who believe that Muhammad ibn Abdullah ibn Abdul Muttalib salawatullahi wa salamhu alayhi is his messenger and is his slave. So indeed, we say, Inna alhamdulillah, all praise is for Allah. We praise Him and we thank Him. We seek Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's help and we seek Allah's assistance from every single evil. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to assist us in performing every single good. Know that whomever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides to this religion is truly guided, and none can mislead such an individual except Allah alone. And know for certain that whomever refuse to follow this religion, whoever refuse to listen and to obey and to practice Islam as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ordained for this religion to be practiced, know that those who go to the extreme in their statements, then there is no guidance for such an individual, whether male or female, whether one or 100 or 1,000,000. And there is nothing that we can do for them except make sincere dua that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rectify their affairs and guide them. For indeed, the hidayah, the guidance, is in the hands of Allah azza wa jal. My dear brothers and sisters, I remind you that you should send your finest peace and blessings on the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. For indeed, although you and I may not be wealthy enough to take a trip to go and to perform Hajj, to go and to perform Umrah, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to enrich us so that we may be able to do so. But even if you don't have that wealth, and you wish and you desire to go in front of the grave of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and to deliver your salam to him, Assalamu alaykum ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, know that from the comfort of your home, that no matter where you are on the earth, or even if you are an astronaut and you are in the heavens, know for certain that when you say, Allahumma صلي على محمد, then the angels will deliver that peace upon Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and will mention you by name to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam that you had sent peace upon him. Know that for every blessing and every peace that you send upon the Prophet, that Allah sends one to you as well. And as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in the Quran, إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ يُسَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ. Indeed, Allah and His angels send blessings on the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Ya ayyuha الذين آمنوا, O you who believe, صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. Send blessings upon him and a worthy salutation. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ordered us to send blessings on the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. It is not a condition that you must hear his name to send blessings upon him, but indeed, if you hear his name, send blessings. But merely, my dear brothers and sisters, while you are walking, while you are driving, send blessings on Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. When you are supplicating to Allah azza wa jal, and you are asking Allah for something, know that from among the perfection of dua, from among the perfection characteristics of making supplication, is that you end your supplication with sending blessings on the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So we say, Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim innaka hamidun majid. Amma ba'du. In today's episode, my dear brothers and sisters, we will be taking a hadith from the Sahih of Imam Bukhari. And the narrator of this hadith is mashhur. It is none other than the illustrious companion, Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu anhu. And we have spoken about Abdullah ibn Umar in previous episodes, but maybe you are joining us for the first time, so we shall review and we shall remind our viewers, for indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that the reminder benefits who? The believer. Abdullah ibn Umar is indeed the son of the second Khalifa of Islam, Umar bin al-Khattab radiallahu anhu. Abdullah ibn Umar was a young boy. He had not even attained the age of 18 before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called the Messenger of Allah back to him, meaning before Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam passed away. But although he was young, he was rashidun, dhakiyun, extremely smart, extremely clever, extremely intelligent. Abdullah ibn Umar was from among the prolific narrators of hadith of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And he was a companion who would strictly guard and practice the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. It is narrated that even when performing Hajj or Umrah, while he would be going towards the Kaaba, heading towards Mecca, he would be with his caravan and with his students, and they would find that he would stop in a certain place, get off of his camel, and just stand. And then he would mount his animal and continue the journey for his Hajj and Umrah. When he was asked by his students, by his disciples, by his companions, why did you stop here randomly? I mean, there's nothing here, it's just desert. What made you stop and get off of your mount? What made you stop and pause here for a minute or two? Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu anhu would say, it is because I saw Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam do this. My dear brothers and sisters, Abdullah ibn Umar did not only practice the sunnah that was an obligation and a duty upon him, but he would practice those behaviors and actions of the Messenger of Allah that was not binding upon us, merely because he loved Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So indeed, it is extremely righteous and noble of Abdullah ibn Umar to follow the Prophet in his example, even in those affairs in which we are not required to follow. In this hadith, again as I mentioned, that is found in the Sahih of Imam Bukhari, Abdullah ibn Umar, he mentions that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam passed by a man who was admonishing his brother. He was talking to his brother, admonishing him. And he said to his brother, you are too shy, and I fear that you being shy is going to harm you. What did he mean? How often do we have in our own family and in our own households people who are very loud and who demand attention, but we also have in our family those who have haya, shyness, who are soft, who are gentle, who does not like to be heard, but just likes to stay silent. One who does not play in large groups, but maybe is reserved and plays by themselves. So often we demand that our sisters have haya, that they have shyness, but we say nothing as it relates to the men. We actually encourage our men not to have shyness, and we think that this is a weak characteristic. We believe that having haya is a characteristic for females only, and that a strong man who demands strength and respect and admiration must be outgoing and must be loud and must knock down doors wherever he go. But indeed, this is the wrong understanding of haya. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, being keen to his society, even to the conversations that he would hear while passing by, when he would see a wrong, he would fix it. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam saw that this person was being oppressed by his brother by telling him and rebuking him because of his haya, because of his shyness. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam turned to them and he said, "Leave him al-haya min al-iman." That haya, shyness, is a part of iman. It is a part of one's faith. My dear brothers and sisters, as I've mentioned before and I will continue to mention, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he often gives us a very detailed explanation, or Rasulullah, he widens the definition of words that you and I may think have one definition, but he adds to it. From among those words is this word of al-haya, shyness. If I asked you, what does it mean to be shy? You would say it would mean to be reserved, to be quiet, not to really speak, to blush when the eyes are upon you, and to maybe not be confident. But indeed, haya is also strength. Being shy when you are around people whom do not know you is a form of strength. But being loud and obnoxious in front of everyone and everyone is a form of weakness. For indeed, the person is only loud and obnoxious when they are in front of the people because they are scared, because they are insecure of themselves. So to win over the audience, they become loud and obnoxious so that the audience does not see and recognize the weaknesses and deficiencies that they feel in and of themselves. But indeed, haya, shyness, is a form of strength, that you are confident, that you are willing to have people look at you and judge you just based on your appearance. And you need not say anything to win them over. And they will either love you or they will either be from among those who pass over you. My dear brothers and sisters, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam teaches us something very important in this hadith. He mentions, al-haya min al-imani. Haya, shyness, is from iman. Shyness is from iman. The iman is the most important thing that is found in the believer. For indeed, the one who has the proper iman will be saved and will enter paradise, insha'Allah. But the one whose iman is weak, the one whose iman is deficient, the one whose iman is corrupted, then this individual, he will be punished on the day of judgment, unless Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is merciful with this individual. A person must make sure that their iman is correct and strong and sound if they want to enter into the paradise of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Not of his paradise, but to enter the paradise to be in his companionship, to be in his company. My dear brothers and sisters, I want to mention to you two individuals who had a high level of iman, and yet they were from among the leaders of this ummah. For those of you who think that iman means that you will never be a leader because you are always shy and you are always reserved, rather, these two people, I will mention them to you, and they were known for their haya. They had incredible shyness, but that did not keep them or prevent them, and it did not harm them in the least. Rather, it made them more capable to fulfill their duties. The first person is none other than Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam himself. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to send his peace and blessings upon the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. It is narrated that the Prophet Muhammad was more shy than even a virgin girl. And yes, a virgin girl, this is a type of statement that was used because it is known that the one who has not had that experience is extremely shy. And we know that our sisters, it is recommended and encouraged for them to practice and to have haya as well. But Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was more shy than even that. He was not one who would go out and strive and struggle to be recognized amongst his peers and in society. Rather, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would be in the masjid, and when the caravans would come and the emissaries would come to meet him and to greet him, they would not be able to tell who was the Prophet and who was his companion. He was shy. He had this hayat. He was a simple individual who was not sitting upon a throne of gold, but rather sat on the floor with his ashabi, with his companions. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was shy, and so the people would be shy around him. And yet, although Rasulullah himself was extremely shy, he was the leader of the Muslim community. He is the leader of the Anbiya, all of the prophets, and he is the best of the sons of Adam, and he was shy. So indeed, my brothers and sisters, shyness is a virtue. Shyness is something that we should strive to have or to practice. Remember that shyness is something that you can practice. If you know that you are loud and if you know that you always demand attention, then fight against yourselves and be shy and be humble and be quiet. You do not always have to speak. You do not always have to be the first one to share your opinion and your thoughts. And when we have those people who are just naturally shy and naturally reserved, then we should not admonish them, but we should assist them and we should make dua for them. And we should ask that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make this haya in us as well. The second individual who had a high level of haya is none other than the third Khalifa, Uthman ibn Affan radiyallahu anhu. It is mentioned that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was once sitting at the well, and Abu Bakr as-Siddiq joined him. And then he was sitting at the same well, and Uthman ibn Affan radiyallahu anhu came, and Umar ibn al-Khattab radiyallahu anhu came. When Abu Bakr came, Rasulullah was sitting as he was sitting, with his feet in the water and his thigh uncovered. When Umar ibn al-Khattab came, he sat and didn't change his position. But when he was informed that Uthman ibn Affan was coming, he covered his thigh and he sat up properly. His wife Aisha radiallahu anha asked, when Abu Bakr came and Umar came, you did not change your position. You sat, your thigh was uncovered and you were comfortable. But when you heard that Uthman was coming, you sat up and you covered yourselves. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, should I not be shy around one whom the angels are shy around? It is mentioned that Uthman ibn Affan was so shy that when he would take a shower, he would even cover himself while taking a shower. Remember, he is standing and no one can see him, but he is still covering himself in his shower because of his shyness. So we know that shyness is a beautiful quality. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us be from among those who love the people who are shy and who assist the people who are shy and not take advantage of them. My dear brothers and sisters, Al-haya min al-iman. I close with reminding you of this principle, that Iman has many parts to it. Our faith have many parts. From among the parts of the faith and the completion of the faith is, as we took in the previous hadith, لَا يُؤْمِنُ أَحَدُكُمْ حَتَّى يُحِبُّ لِأَخِهِ مَا يُحِبُّ لِنَفْسِهِ. Loving for your brother what you love for yourself, this is a sign of the completion of Iman. As well as haya, shyness is also part and parcel with Iman and having belief in Allah Azza wa Jal. My dear brothers and sisters, the next time that you see a brother being taken advantage because of his shyness, then speak up for him and remind him and remind the one who is admonishing him that shyness and haya should be praised and is a praiseworthy quality to have, and that indeed it is a part of Iman. Likewise, when you have siblings or maybe you have children of your own, you may find some of your children are more outgoing than the other. And you may wish that those children of yours who are shy were just as spontaneous and courageous as the other siblings. Know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created us differently. And the strength that you see in the one who is courageous is also the strength is found in the one who is shy. For shyness is a part of this religion. My dear brothers and sisters, shyness is not something that we should only be worried regarding the women in our religion, but shyness is something that should be found amongst the men of this ummah. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us, to make us steadfast upon His religion. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us paradise and to protect us from the fire of hell. اللهم ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
ITV.